All right, so that's a reminder of what Yapster is, EGO, engage, grow, optimize. So where does what we're going to talk about today fit within that? Well, it fits really within the grow part of our agenda. It's about driving engagement and business outcomes through communication and leadership. Now, most of you watching are leaders of your organization, and you're fantastic at talking to your people and inspiring them to go the extra mile or do the right thing for customers. But what we've realized actually is that the teams really do enjoy a bit of friendly competition between one another, and you all use classic league tables, and you've got KPIs from your EPOS systems that you usually print out and put on staff room boards. So we thought, what could we do with that to innovate within the context of Yapster to help you deliver your growth agenda? And this is what we came up with. KPI gamification. So what is KPI gamification? It's taking all that data that you already have and the campaigns that you're already running and turning it into a social interaction within our platform to drive your business outcomes. In this case, it's about driving sales most often. Why does it work? It works because it's inherently social and people are motivated to upsell or drive a given KPI, not just because it helps you as the business leader hit your business plan, but because it's fun for them and they get bragging rights over a rival. So let's just pull up on screen so you can see what this looks like. And in a minute, I'm going to do a live demo so actually we can go more deeply into this. Okay, so first point to make is KPI gamification is delivered through the very same interface that you already have in your Yapster platform. What that means is it means that you're not going to confuse people. You're not going to undermine any of your core cultural or communication strategies. It just sits nicely on top of that. So if you look at the image on the left, you've got your recent Yaps list. KPI gamification is delivered through Yaps. And again, I'll show you this in a second. But if you look at the middle image, you can see a gamification Yap. This is an automatically created conversation between participating sites where Yapster creates the chat for you and then publishes information to that chat to get the teams going. And that's where we come on to the last image on the right, the scoreboard that's driven by the EPOS data. And I'll talk a bit more about that in a moment. And you can see in this example, Edinburgh and Soho are competing on a conversion percentage for drinks. And you can see that Soho is beating Edinburgh by 25%. So before I show you the live demo, how do we actually make this work? How do we get it set up so that you can get your Yapster instance functioning in this way and delivering this exciting new functionality? Well, the first thing to say is we need to agree who the teams are. Well, because Yapster already integrates with your HR system, we already have an exhaustive log of which sites there are in your location. So all you have to do is decide which sites are going to serve as teams for the purposes of a run of games. Then what you need to decide is you need to decide what do you want your teams to achieve. So one of the customers that we designed this with and tested early with is the Revere division of the Marsden's PLC pub group. And in their case, they were interested to see if they could get the teams to enrich the customer experience and serve customers slightly more attentively by making sure that customers didn't go without coffees or desserts after they've enjoyed a main. So in that case, it was about selecting coffees or desserts as the targeted item to focus the teams on competing to sell more. All we need to do then is interact with your EPOS provider or the accounting team in your business to get a nightly feed of sales data so that we can see of the sites you selected, how are they doing on a day-to-day basis in terms of selling the item that we've identified. Now, we already integrate with your HR system, so this is not significantly more complicated than that. And it's something that our guide dog support team will be very happy to facilitate for you if you do want to pick up this module after watching this demo. So once we've got the EPOS in place, it's actually pretty straightforward. We've picked the teams. We know the competition that we're going to run. All the data is ready to go. You just tell us when you want to go live. And then the sales games run, which is what I'm going to show you now. And per our early tests with Marsden's, this does increase sales. In their case, it was a 7% increase in like-for-like sales on coffee and desserts and versus a control group, i.e. those that were not participating in the games, to take out any seasonal fluctuations or otherwise. So the teams loved it. It really did make a difference. And it made a difference both to their engagement with each other, because of course the sites are talking to each other, but also with those campaign items that otherwise are quite difficult to motivate teams to think about selling. So let me come out of this presentation now and go on to my instance of Yapster that you will be able to hopefully see. And we can see what this looks like live. Right, so this is my Yapster instance. You'll recognize the interface, I hope, either from using it in your business or from the demo that I just showed. So the first thing to note is, look, there are two Yaps here that are relevant to this competition. So the first one is the conversation that Yapster initially starts with all of the participating teams. So what Yapster does is it creates the chat and it publishes an image initially that summarizes what the game is going to be about. So in this case, we work in hospitality and we work in retail. This is one that we've been testing for a retail customer. They're in the eyewear business. And so this game is going to be about anti-reflection ophthalmic lenses as a percentage of overall sales. So the Yapster announces that to the teams that are participating. It explains the way that this is going to work. So a knockout round competition. And there's a visual cue there to show, hey, it's going to be a knockout tournament between these participating teams. And then the Yapster platform will create a bot that also then says, hey, the game's about to start and here's what's happening. Now, where your colleagues come in is all the things you would expect from Yapster already. So people are going to be talking to each other with GIFs, images, app mentions, emojis, basically talking to each other. Of course, the obligatory Yoda GIF. Talking to each other as we do, playful, competitive, community spirit. And then in between those manual contributions that the colleagues will tend to pile into the chat and contribute, Yapster will pop up and share results. And I'm going to come back to this in a second. But just to explain here, in the qualifier round, Yapster's updated and it's explained to people where they've got to. And what you can see here is Blackpool were playing Belfast and Blackpool has won. Cardiff were playing Oxford and Cardiff has won, right? So that is the primary game chat. But of course, whilst you've got all of the teams in a conversation to see what's going on, what you also have, and this is where it gets really special, you have individual chats featuring just two sites. And so what that means is there's a real head-to-head rivalry between two individual locations competing on whatever your gamified metric is. Now, the reason this is interesting, well, it's interesting for lots of reasons, but one of the reasons we find it very interesting is in an environment like the one we're going into now, where we think there's going to be an initial spike in volumes as the economy fully reopens, but there may be actually slightly subdued footfall afterwards. And in any case, no one really knows what their business plan is going to look like in a sort of like-for-likes context, because it's very hard to compare to last year. So it might be that all of your teams are massively above or massively below their business plan. The cool thing about doing head-to-head gamification is you can win or lose a match by just being more above plan than your opponent or being less below plan than your opponent. So if you're in hospitality with lots of outdoor space and it rains, it might depress sales for everybody. But actually, this will squeeze out discretionary effort and still make it engaging, even if sales are down. So this is why it's driving such significant sales uplift performance. So what you can see here is we've got the final between Blackpool and Cardiff. I'm going to go into the eye icon. And what you can see is Cardiff and Blackpool are in this chat. And we've also got two observers. So Yapster will allow you, potentially as a leadership team or regional leadership, to automatically be added to the site level matches that you want to participate in. So here we go, Cardiff versus Blackpool with Jenny and Ben participating. So the Yapster persona has announced that this game happens to be the final round. It starts on the 13th and ends on the 14th because we're obviously presenting today on the 14th of May. And we wanted to be able to show you the live outcome. So Ben's piped up with some motivational chat. Jenny has pushed back. We know which side they're on. Again, we've got more. Oh, this is me teasing with a GIF earlier. We've got more banter coming in. And so what would happen now is as the teams were talking to each other, they'd be doing the sales and you'd just be tracking that in EPOS. And as you've just seen here up on the screen, as you get to the end of the game, Yapster will automatically publish the score to say the match is now finished. These are the results. And you can see this one was seriously close. So So the team in Cardiff are going to feel very sour, I'm sure. So Blackpool's the winner. Again, all of this is happening automatically. So if you think when you've done incentives in the past, the amount of manual administration that would have been required to run competitions at much smaller scale than this. So here's Lena gloating. And we've got some emojis. I'm actually going to give a thumbs up as well to the winners here. And of course, it's not over, because actually with these games, we can just keep running these. So whilst teams might be temporarily set back by having lost this match, there's always the next game. And just like in sport, what we're seeing with this is, rather than it getting old over time, it actually gets more interesting, because now we're starting to build organizational rivalry and teams have got the opportunity to win in the next match when they lost the last one. So unlike in a static KPI league table, just going to stop sharing that so you can see my main screen again. And you're going to see the banter is going to keep flowing now, as it will in your organization when you turn this on. So as I was saying, in a regular static league, when you publish your scores, quite often teams will get disaffected with, oh, I'm never going to win this league, it's over, I'm going to give up now. And so it only motivates those at the top. In a match play situation, actually, you get the chance to, there's always the next match. And so you get to reset, start again, motivate the team again as you go. So you can see why we're hopefully you can see why we're so excited about this. Just up on the screen now, you can see some of the key summary drivers of value for this. Coming out of lockdown, we all need to focus on customer-centric behavior that drives business outcomes. The whole world runs on data now. We know this. And making data accessible to people is not an easy thing to do. So the thing we love about gamification is it actually makes data relevant at the very the most local level, not just to your finance team or your marketing team. And competition and recognition. An unexpected but lovely consequence of this feature is that we've seen, or we're beginning to see, that it's actually helping teams that work near each other but don't necessarily know each other begin to feel real camaraderie. Because of course, in the games, they're talking to each other in a way that they normally don't on day-to-day trading. That ultimately drives up engagement. We think it's also going to reduce labor turnover as a result, whilst boosting sales. So that was a whistle-stop tour. I hope you found it useful and exciting. I hope you are ready to win. So the last thing for me to do is to thank you for your attention. And I'm just going to open up the questions now, and then we can wrap up. Okay, so we've got a couple of questions that have come in. Is it possible to run games at very large or very small scale? Yes, it is. There's no limit to the upper limit. You obviously want the games to be, it slightly depends on the format and how quickly you want it to run. If it's a knockout tournament, then you'll know the time by which you'll get to the final pair. You can run as many games as you want within your organization. So you might run an all organization tournament, or you might run tournaments within areas. So it's really flexible in that sense. Another question that's come in is there any restrictions on the KPIs that can be gamified? No, there's not. As long as you can deliver nightly reliable EPOS data to us, where the relevant metrics are presented, or it can be a series, we don't mind how many KPIs you deliver to us, and we can just pick out the relevant ones with each game that we configure. So again, that will help to keep this really fresh. Just got a comment coming in here from Ed. This is such a good idea. Generating healthy competition is a great way to incentivize performance. But what makes this so special is the real-time element of communication. Sending out reports on progress monthly destroys the energy of his incentives. Ed says he needs this in his life. Thank you so much, Ed, and everybody for joining. I'm just going to give it a minute to see if you've got any other questions. But otherwise, those of us that are on the customer-facing side of Yapster, we're going to be reaching out through next week and beyond to get some proof of concepts of this running for you so that you can enjoy it for yourself. And we're going to keep investing in this module. Next, we're going to be looking at evolving leagues, but I won't tell too much because we're hopefully going to give you some exciting new news in the next feature showcase. But we will be investing a lot in this. So we're looking forward to hearing your ideas so that we can co-innovate and make it better based on your imaginations. Okay, we've just had a couple more questions come in. How much does it cost? So we've started billing this on a quarterly basis because we know that not everyone wants to run games all of the time. So we bill this on a per active user basis. So normally we bill Yapster on a per profile basis for the core platform because we let you try the product so you know what you're getting into before you sign up. Once you sign up after a trial, it's incumbent upon the organization to use the platform and communicate in healthy ways. We call that social leadership. With gamification, of course, you can only influence sales for people that are on the platform. So we bill on an active user basis per quarter. What EPOS systems do we currently integrate with? We're very excited that we're integrating with Polaris, with Brewhouse and Kitchen at the moment. We can also take data feeds via CSV from finance teams. So in Marsden's, the feed came not directly from their EPOS provider, but from their they already had their existing feed and then were able to deliver that into a secure nightly folder for us via finance. We will integrate, we will deliver the data feed in whatever way you need us to, provided that you can get it to us nightly with the relevant fields in. Who do we need to speak to get this set up? So email either the guide dog team, support@yapster.info, or you can use the help app in your Yapster app, or you can yap or email me personally and I will, I'll get the team going on a configuration for you. Just ask if someone can get a copy of the presentation to share with key stakeholders. Yes, absolutely. We'll be releasing probably a recording of this presentation along with the slides so that people can talk about this internally. And our intention thereafter is to set up proof of concept so that, because this is a fresh feature, and as far as we know, this is a world first. We don't think that there's any parallel for this anywhere else in any communication tech in the world, actually, because we invented it. So we recognize that you're going to need to try it in order to understand its full potential. How long does it take to set up? It really depends on how long it takes us to get the nightly data rolling and then the complexity of the matches that you want to organize. But we're not expecting it to be more than a few weeks. It does depend on the volume, and unsurprisingly, I guess, because this combines social, comms and sales, and the last thing precious to all of us. The appetite for this seems to be very high, so we're starting to build a wait list. If you are interested, please get in touch quickly, because the time it's going to take to deploy will depend on where you are in the queue of customers that have just signed up for it. And then finally, one last question. Do you have to select one specific product, or can it be a group of products, i.e. high-end wines, or would we have to choose one specific wine? If the data can be presented to us in a way where you know the bundle, then it can be whatever, it can be your mix. We will work with you during configuration to understand how it can work. What most people are doing is they're just changing games quarter to quarter. So they'll pick a given wine and then premium gin and coffees and desserts, or in the retail side, it might be sofas, then, you know, ties or accessories if you're in apparel. And then we mentioned one of our other retailers is just looking at different eyewear products quarter to quarter. Okay, thank you so much for all of your questions. Really excited to get going on this with you. If you don't already, please follow us on LinkedIn and on our other social channels, at Yapster Chat on Twitter, I think on Instagram as well. We're going to be sharing this sort of these tidbits of innovation as we keep investing in this through the quarter until our next feature showcase, which I think will be in mid to late August. And again, we'll record it and circulate for those of you that hopefully are on holiday, hopefully overseas by then. So that's it from me. Thank you everybody for participating. Can't wait to get going with you. Bye for now.